While the fascination with flip clocks may have had its beginning in North America, flip clock fans can now be found all over the world. The problem for collectors of these clocks outside of the United States and Canada is that many of these clocks will not properly work in their countries because of the differences in the electrical systems. You see, while the United States uses an electrical system consisting of 110 to 120 volts, running at 60 hertz, most of the world uses higher voltage, 220 to 240, running at 50 hertz. The first possible mistake a new flip clock owner can make is to simply get a plug adapter. Just getting an adapter does nothing to make a US clock work with a different electrical system. Yes, you'll be able to plug it in, then immediately you'll smell the internal clock's transformer burning up. Oops! The voltage first has to be stepped down from the higher voltage to around 110 to 120 volts. But what's this about frequency? Household current is alternating current. That means the current changes direction or polarity rapidly. The rate of direction or polarity change is called the frequency. 60 Hz simply means 60 cycles per second. When alternating current changes direction, it does so in a particular pattern. On a device that displays or graphs this change over time, an oscilloscope, the output, is a smooth sine wave. Vintage flip clocks are run by synchronous motors. A synchronous motor has a speed exactly proportional to the frequency. The flip clock is geared specifically to the motor, and the motor of clocks intended for use in North America requires a frequency of 60 Hz to result in the flipping of the clock tiles properly. If you run such a clock with 50 Hz, you'll lose 12 minutes every hour. So now we know we must get a device that changes both voltage and frequency. So why not get a cheap one? There are some budget shaver transformers meant to do this, for example. In a cheaper device, the frequency is changed to 60 Hz, but the wave output is often a modified sine wave, which looks like a chopped up rectangular wave, not the smooth sine wave that the clock was designed to accept. Many electronic devices will not run smoothly and quietly with this waveform, and noise isn't something you want on your nightstand. That's where Ken's Clock Clinic comes to the rescue. KensClockClinic.com. Ken has spent over two decades working with vintage electric and historical self-winding clocks and maintains an excellent website offering information and products for these types of clocks. Of great interest to the flip clock fan, however, are his frequency-precise power inverters. Specifically, the model 1930-115V will take 220 to 240 volts at 50 Hz and output a very stable 115-volt alternating current at 60 Hz with a pure sine wave. The model 1930-115V is triple protected against faults, making it safe in the home. While the device may seem costly, it's actually priced less than other inverters and produces a scientific-grade output. It's certainly less costly than locating and buying another flip clock to replace the one damaged by other products. And the model 1930-115V comes with everything you need, including your country-specific plug adapter, saving you a lot of running around. If you don't want your vintage clock to just sit on a shelf, and if you don't want it destroyed by plugging it into the wrong power or the wrong converter, go to KensClockClinic.com and choose the products link. Thanks for watching. When you get the time, come visit us at FlipClockFans.com.